There is a very interesting technique that a lot of people kind of question about whether it's either canon or whether it's possible to actually use in the series, like in a non-filler arc. And that mysterious technique is called the Super Kaioken. Hello everyone, it's 18 here, and welcome to another Dragon Ball discussion. Today, I'm going to be talking about the super interesting Super Kaioken, no pun intended. So essentially, this technique was only used once in the series, and this is added to its immense speculation because it was used in a filler arc. If some of you guys watched Dragon Ball Kai, it was used in an arc that's only in Dragon Ball Z, the original, because essentially it was used in a filler arc. If you're not aware, a filler arc is essentially a section of the anime which was made that wasn't featured in the original manga by Akira Toriyama. And when people refer to canon, they are essentially saying, like, is it the canon of the series, which is mostly based off the manga? And because this section of the anime, this filler arc, wasn't in Toriyama's manga, a lot of people think that the arc's completely, like, taken out of the main story and it's just for fun on the side. However, if you weren't aware, Akira Toriyama actually was involved in this arc. He didn't write all of it, but he basically gave Toei, like, the rough outline of the arc. I think he designed literally all the different fighters in the actual tournament that Goku faces, such as the Bug Man and the... I can't remember their names. There's, like, this Caterpillar Man, which Goku fights, and also this fighter that, you know, uses water to his advantage, and Goku has some fun fights against them. And he also designed Paikuhan, or PyCon in the English dub. And yeah, Toriyama designed those characters and, like, their moves and things like that. So although the Otherworld tournament is technically a filler arc, Toriyama did have quite a bit of input in its creation. So I'm not saying it's, like, canon, but, like, Toriyama essentially had quite a bit to do with it. So let's get into talking about the actual topic of this video now we've got all this laid out. So essentially, a lot of people say because the Super Kaioken was used in this filler arc only once, and it's never been used again since this filler arc, like, it's not something Goku should be able to do. I'm gonna kind of talk about my thoughts about this from what we can see in the series. So let's first do a refresher on the Kaioken. If you guys have forgotten or you need a little refresher, essentially, you probably remember it from Dragon Ball Super, because it was obviously in Super with Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken. But there's a reason why it was used in Super, and it kind of goes full circle. So essentially in Super, Goku uses the Kaioken with the Super Saiyan God. And a lot of you people are thinking, well, if he can use it as a Super Saiyan God, why didn't he originally use it as a Super Saiyan? Because that obviously would come in very handy against Cell. Because with the Kaioken, if you remember, Goku could control how many times he times his power by with the Kaioken. For example, against Frieza, he did a times 10 and even times 20, I believe. I know he did the Kamehameha Kaioken times 10, and he's done times 20 before in, you know, Dragon Ball Super with the Super Saiyan Blue form. But the original problem with the Kaioken was that, if you remember, when Goku becomes a Super Saiyan, and when any Saiyan becomes a Super Saiyan, apart from the new technique of going Super Saiyan in Dragon Ball Super, they had to kind of rely on anger to trigger the transformation. Because when Goku first turned Super Saiyan, and every other time after that, he used the anger that he felt when Krillin got killed to transform. The same with Vegeta, and the same with Gohan, really. So the problem with the Kaioken originally was that when someone uses the Kaioken, aka Goku, they had to be in complete control of their emotions and in complete control of their energy. And the problem was, even when Goku 100% mastered the Super Saiyan form, and he didn't have to be really angry to, like, trigger, like, keep it up, there's always that flare of anger when you first transform. So you guys can't forget that. But basically, the problem with the Kaioken is, because Super Saiyan is naturally a kind of unstable form, if that makes sense, because of all the flaring energy, there's an extremely high risk that the person using it, if they use the Kaioken on top of that, would just die. And I know you guys are thinking, well, Goku's used the Kaioken a lot of times in the past, like, what's different when he's a Super Saiyan? Basically, when Goku's used it in the past, he wasn't a Super Saiyan until that other world arc, because he basically could control his ki properly, and there was nothing kind of on top of it kind of making it more complicated. So if he was a Super Saiyan, his energy would be flaring around, and, you know, that's not 100% controlled. So originally, he wouldn't be able to just use it because he would basically die from the Kaioken kind of malfunctioning. But the reason he can use it in Dragon Ball Super is because, as a Super Saiyan God, he has complete control over his ki. If you remember, Whis basically says, like, to become a Super Saiyan God, you have to, like, have complete control of your ki. And because Goku essentially has 100% control of his ki in Super Saiyan Blue form, he can use the Kaioken because he doesn't have as big of a risk of kind of damaging his body, like, critically, and potentially killing himself through the Kaioken. Like, although when he first uses it, he's not sure if it would work. There's a lot more of a safety net compared to the original Super Saiyan because he doesn't have lots of ki like flaring around all the time, and he can control when that ki's coming out. So when he's using the Kaioken, you know, he can control it properly. And this will probably lead to some of you wondering, like, well, if, you know, in the Otherworld tournament back in Dragon Ball Z, how come Goku could use the Kaioken with the Super Saiyan form? And that is a good question, and that's a big reason why people say, well, the form isn't canon, because it makes no sense, because Goku would just die. But if you remember, in the Otherworld tournament, this takes place right after Goku sacrificed himself to save the planet from Cell blowing up and, you know, destroying the planet. So technically, Goku was already dead when he uses the Super Kaioken in the Otherworld tournament. And although it is possible to lose your body in the afterlife, if you remember, in the afterlife, a person's body, well, a spirit who's actually kept their body, Goku's obviously a special exception. If you remember, not every person who dies keeps their body. It's mainly people that have done great things, you know, when they were alive. So Goku has his own body in basically the other world. And yeah, if you remember, in the Buu saga, Goku trains he basically trains using the Super Saiyan 3 form in the other world on King Kai's planet. And when he's actually fighting Buu, when he's alive again for a day, he says, I can't keep Super Saiyan 3 up as long as I could in the afterlife because my body's less durable. And that is probably the biggest bit of evidence I could kind of find. Because if you think about it, if his body's a lot more durable in the afterlife, and he could keep Super Saiyan 3 up much longer and take much more, like, physical strain in the afterlife, because obviously he is already dead. In the Otherworld tournament, Goku could probably use the Super Kaioken, because even if he messed it up a little bit, he probably could still take the strain and not lose his body. Whereas if he's alive and fighting back in Dragon Ball Z against Cell, he is under a very stressful situation, and he wouldn't be able to control his ki, you know, very well, just like in the Otherworld tournament. But instead, he doesn't have that safety net, so his body's can take less strain, and he'd most definitely die by using the Kaioken while he's alive. So I think the bottom line that I've kind of gathered and took evidence from the series is that it's not that he couldn't use Super Kaioken before, it just wasn't beneficial. Because when you think about it, the Super Saiyan transformation times a Saiyan's base power by 50, and the Kaioken can perhaps double, triple, or, you know, go beyond whatever the Super Saiyan form could do by stacking it on top of Super Saiyan. However, because the Super Saiyan form originally kind of has ki flowing everywhere and he can't control it 100%, he would basically 99.9% of the time be dead by using it. And Goku obviously can't do that in a situation where he needs to help the Z Fighters fight Cell or any other threat, because if he just straight up dies, the whole Earth's probably going to be destroyed. So I guess some of you guys could say, like, well, he could have used it anyway because he wanted Gohan to kill Cell, but if Goku wasn't there to support Gohan originally, I don't think Gohan wouldn't have gotten as far as he did. So I think, technically, although it's a filler arc, Goku could use Kaioken while, you know, in his Super Saiyan form. It's just that he chose not to because he would die. So that's the bottom line that I've kind of gathered. If you guys agree with me, let me know. And if you guys disagree, let me know. Comment in the comments, like, your theories about why Goku didn't try at least to use the Super Kaioken, or whether you just think it's a kind of filler technique. However, when you actually look at the situation Goku's in the Otherworld tournament against Paikuhon, he breaks out of Paikon's hyper tornado attack, and then he uses the Super Kaioken extremely briefly, I might add, to kind of catch Paikuhon off guard and punch him to knock him out the way. And from what we can see, Goku used that Kaioken as an opening to use his Kamehameha to try and, you know, beat Paikon, but Paikuhon basically just punched him while he was charging it up. But from what we can see, Goku uses the Super Kaioken really, really fast, and he basically only uses it for one punch. So that kind of tells you how much of a strain that would have put on his body. However, he knew he could, you know, try the Super Kaioken because he's already dead and he can, you know, strain his body a lot more. And I think if Goku was alive and fighting on Earth against Pokémon in like a tournament, if he tried doing that on like Earth, I think he would like die instantly by trying to use it. I think his body would probably explode because, yeah, if you mess up the Kaioken, you basically either die or your body explodes from the stupid amount of energy that's being amplified into it and through it. So yeah, that's what I think the Super Kaioken technically is something Goku could use, but he just chose not to because he knew it was an extremely high risk, and King Kai already told him a million times in the Saiyan saga that the Kaioken was extremely dangerous and he could die by going over times two or times three, I think he said. So yeah, that's what I think about the Super Kaioken. And if you guys learned anything from this discussion, please leave a like on the video and let me know if you enjoyed it, because I just started this series and yeah, I just want to know what you guys think of it. So also comment on other things you want me to discuss or other theories you want me to talk about in this series. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to get notifications from whenever I upload a video. I have a Discord which you can join, the link to it's in the description. I have a Twitter you can follow, and I also have a Patreon. If you want to help this channel get off the ground, because I'm not monetized yet, it would really mean a lot to me, but you know, it's up to you. But the link to my Patreon's in the description too. But more importantly, I hope you guys have a great day. And also, don't forget everyone, subscribe to me, because I'm definitely 18.